Oh, hello there. You caught me watching myself playing Dark Souls Remastered. Yes. But while you're here, you're probably wondering how did I get that ghostly little controller on the bottom right of the video there? And wow, once YouTube is done chewing through the video, that looks a bit rough. But yeah, that, what you see down here, is called Open Joystick Display. That is the teeny tiny little bit of software that's it's actually Electron based, so good use of Electron in my opinion. And it has, of course, a Linux version. Well, three of them, if the downloads are anything to go by. The portable, the Debian package, and the app image. I'll leave whichever one you'd like up to you, but I'm going to download the portable version. We do that. It downloads only like 100 megs, so not the end of the world there, and then we just extract that to the software folder. Good enough for me. And then we'll go to the software folder, which is right here. And yeah, it's this generic looking icon right here, Open Joystick Display. You just open it and boom, there it is. So, how do we go from here? And that's a very yellow background. How do we go from here to OBS? Well, conveniently, I have OBS open. So, let's this recording scene right here, we'll just add a thing, namely a window capture. I could cheat and just add the controller, but I'm gonna do it for your sake. I'm going to do it the long way around. And that's the other desktop. No, we don't want that. We want this. There we go. Now, you don't want all of that, obviously. You could crop it, but Open Joystick Display is clever enough that you can just click, as it says on the title bar here. You just hit the escape key to toggle broadcast mode. That's it. That's all you need. And the very, very yellow background is the chroma key color key. This is the value we're going to need for chroma keying it properly in OBS. This is, of course, for the DualShock. If I move the DualShock here, you can see things happen and things light up. Yes. And, oh, pro tip for DualShock owners, if you're going to use this, plug the DualShock in. It doesn't work as well over Bluetooth. I don't know why, but it doesn't. So, once you're ready to edit and everything is configured and all the buttons are registered, hit escape. Ooh, look, that's a much more manageable window. So we'll just move it in the scene somewhere else. And from here, we're going to add a filter. That filter is called Chroma Key. We could just call it Chroma Key. And we're going to set a custom color. Not green, not blue or magenta, because, well, all of those colors are in the DualShock 4. Green is the triangle, magenta is a square, and of course blue is a cross. So what we're going to do is we're going to select a color, paste in that. Of course it doesn't paste. Okay, try again. There we go. Now it pastes. All right. So, going back to the window, you can already see the scene there. It's already working exactly as intended. But you may not want like a solid controller. So what you're going to do is you're going to reduce the opacity to like 60%. And then say we load a game like Brick Simulator. That's a big game. And we add that game to our scene. Yes, the window is called Ven. and there we go. You have the controller, and you can see it registers the button presses over the game. How about that? That's it. That's all you need to do. Have a good one. Don't forget to check linuxgamecast.com for the schedule for when we do our live streams, and of course, all the videos we've recorded thus far. And if you'd like to, follow us on Twitch. That's twitch.com/linuxgamecast. See you out there. Have a good one.